from this coming Saturday.
13 days
away marks the fourth annual Perfect 13 Foundation Celebrity Golf Tournament. Perfect 33 Foundation. Let me try again. The Perfect33Foundation.org Celebrity Perfect 33 Foundation.
By the way, we're doing it for brain surgery. Brain trauma.
All right, to get you in there and get you tested.
The tournament host is David Wells. He joins us with one of his dear friends, Jeremy Roenick, an NHL icon. You're David, you're Jeremy. I've got that part down.
Sure?
Guys,
if I shave my head, you'd never know the difference. Trust me.
Welcome to KUSI. Good to have you here.
Thank you.
Great.
Thanks for having us.
Perfect33Foundation.org. Perfect33Foundation.org. Why is this golf tournament so important, Boomer?
It is for our military guys, our Navy SEALs, to get them the treatments that they so deservedly need. Our VA ain't helping these guys out on these things, so getting them for traumatic brain injury. So this is the money all goes to our military guys, mostly our Navy SEALs, because I'm dear to those guys 100%.
We're looking at some of the tournament. This is video from last year. Obviously, as big a draw as you are, you can't do it by yourself. You need other people to get the foursomes together. Right. We're taking a little peek at some of the people you have playing. Right. I changed the spelling, tried to get the spelling correct in all the names. Could you talk?
I'm an athlete, not a mathlete.
This is just some
Look
of the folks.
List. Look at that list.
Jeremy, I should have put you on top. I apologize for
no,
that.
But are you kidding me?
Could you talk a little bit about how you're kind of on the golf circuit? You play in other people's events, they play in yours. It's kind of give and take, right?
It is. And then I played with a lot of these guys up in Tahoe with Jeremy, where I met Jeremy about 12 years ago. So, you know, we all were retired. So a lot of us just do everybody's, and we give the love. We do their charity events, they do mine, and we just spread the love all over.
Jeremy, growing up in the Midwest, you're quite the icon. Everyone knows about you and your Black Hawk days.
Yep.
I'm curious. I know you're an exceptional hockey player, but that slap shot, how does it affect
your
golf?
Very similar. Slap shots, it's if you can get the right hand out of the golf swing, because a slap shot is all right hand, you're going to have a pretty good golf swing. So plus the seasons coexist. So we play hockey in the winter, play some golf in the summer. Big forearms, strong hands, but it's the eye-hand coordination. You don't think it'd be so hard to hit a golf ball that doesn't move. Right, but that be able to have that eye-hand coordination is very, very keen to hockey players. Hitting that puck when it's coming at you 30, 40 miles an hour, putting it the right place that you want. So that's a really important part between both.
I'm sure you can still find the corner of the crease of the net. Can you? How is he? Can he hit the ball straight?
Yeah. He's just an athlete. So he takes my club. I'm left-handed. Flips it over and hits it about 300 down the middle. That's how talented this one. So he hits it better than me with my club.
He's a legitimate scratch golf. What do you play to?
12 now. I'm going the wrong
you're
way.
Always in the woods. For those who don't know, everyone
for
knows, you have made the transition from being an athlete to talking about athletes.
Exactly.
Can you talk? Tell me it was harder than it looks, because you're making it look really easy.
For me, it was really easy because number one, I had an opinion. And I had a mouth, and I had a big mouth with an opinion. The best place to be is for television. And I was never afraid of the red light that went over a camera. I don't know if you know the Cindy Brady days, right? When she went to camera, she gets one of those. I never had that problem with a camera. So for me, it was an easy transition. My biggest problem, Paul, which you'll probably understand, is I had so much to say, but they only gave me 15 or 20 seconds to say it. So I had to try to find a condense it. That was the biggest problem that I had.
You have to give single thoughts.
Yeah, well,
single thoughts.
Yeah, well, good
expand
luck with
on
me.
One th-
yeah, yeah, I can't find one. I have 100 in there. I got to try to go against.
He was a national pundit for the longest time.
This guy, by the way, he's as close to Charles Barkley in baseball as I am to hockey, as Charles is to basketball. So you put us all together. We know our sport so well, and he's not afraid to tell you what he thinks either, which was make him so good on television.
I think we have video of you.
I'm coaching high school, and he's still on NBC.
Well, how long did you do your network?
4 years with TBS. It was great.
That was a big...
Look at
all the cool clothes. Did you get to keep the clothes?
I bought them, so yeah. I didn't get the luxury of having these designers make my suit, and plus they needed extra cloth.
So, I mean, what did you say that got you knocked off that?
Nothing. They just went a different direction. Oh, a guy named Pedro Martinez?
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, there you go.
Boomer, to me, you're still the bigger star.
I appreciate it.
Yeah. While we're talking about Boston, you're a native from...
I am a Boston guy.
Were you watching the Red Sox or Patriots last night?
I was watching the Patriots. I am a big Patriots fan. I was clicking back and forth to the Boston game. But what happened in the Patriots game last night, I don't advocate I'm not an advocate of anything that happens with any kind of hand gestures or anything like that. No matter how many championships you won, like we do in Boston, we're a very championship-oriented city.
You know you're not well. The Boston sports fan is just not well-liked.
Well, it's a race between Boston and Philly.
I think
Philly.
It's right here,
yeah,
is it not?
There it is, yeah. This is just, it's just
a not, beer was thrown, come on!
Yeah, well, listen, I mean, I played in two of the biggest, the craziest cities in the world for fans, Chicago and Philadelphia. They say in Philly that they even boo Santa Claus, which probably...
They do.
Yeah, they probably do.
They do.
But Boston, I think, is right on par in terms of the most radical, crazy fans.
Now, who'd they play last night?
Kansas City.
And the quarterback for Kansas City?
Mahomes.
Okay.
Mahomes. Yeah.
His dad was the losing pitcher in my perfect game. His dad.
No way.
Oh, my
boomer. How about that? See,
you always add a little somebody to the conversation. That's going to be in the replay.
That's unbelievable.
That's yourself four foursomes.
Speaking of which, we have four foursomes. We'll get to that. We'll take $10 off if you do it in the next 2 hours.
That's right.
All right. Thanks for giving me the heads up on you leaving the Point Loma coaching ranks.
It's time to go.
Boomer.
Happy wife, happy life. You know, it's one of those things, but just got really complicated. This last past season was pretty tough. Some undermining, some just a lot of this and that, and you know, some parents not too happy. So they know more than me. So let them go.
Politics.
It can
politics
be
politics and everything.
Politics ruin everything.
All right, let me do this.
But I'm still a pointer.
Yeah, of course.
Always
you are.
A pointer.
We're gonna bring the graphic up, Boomer. I want you to. This is the. Go to perfect33foundation.org or call that phone number. There are four foursomes left. And
Can I put this plug in?
Yeah.
Just because
you got 15
seconds. Because David is the one who puts it on. I'm the one that plays in it more. It's the best charity golf tournament you'll ever be in. The entertainment, the celebrities, the auction items are absolutely unbelievable. This guy knows how to put on a golf tournament. I will tell you. Four left. If you're not there, you're going to miss out on one of the best times here
just
in Arizona.
Just need some deep pockets. That's all.
Boy, you have
it's for
some.
Our military.
I'm telling you.
For our Navy SEALs.
Are you going to slip them 100 when you hit the parking lot?
I'm serious. It's
the best. Got a free bet at the Casa.
It's the best.
Jeremy, it was an honor to meet you.
Pleasure, Paul.
Boomer.
Thank you.
It's always fun
Paul,
to hang out with you.
Always a pleasure.
Tonight on the All Sports Report, there were three make good football games from Friday night's lightning storm. We have highlights from all three. That St. Augustine-Madison game. You have to see how it ended. Trust me, it's worth sticking around for another hour. All right, the KUSI News at 5 p.m. is over. The KUSI News at 6 p.m. is about to begin.